Hi, Pisces. It is me, Alex, and I'm here to bring you your weekly tarot. I hope you guys are doing well. Let's see what the good universe has for you, Pisces. Ooh, going back and forth. Well, juggling, Six of Cups. Unsure, uncertain about a new love. This person could be rigid and lacks emotion. Oh, and you're trying to figure out what you're going to do. Soul searching. This is Cancer, right? It's a water sign like yourself. And I feel like whomever you're dealing with could act like your father instead of your lover. They're very rigid, could be very cold, very blunt. And I feel like you want love, so now you're trying to figure out, do I want to stay with this person? Or do I want this person to return? Justice. Ten of Swords. Star card. Yep, I have all air signs on the table. I don't know if you would do great with an air sign, especially in their moon or Venus positions. I feel like you owe someone an answer, right? You have a choice to make, trying to figure out the right choice for yourself and maybe this person or situation. I'm going to say this because I kind of get that you want to love this. Whatever it is, a person, a project, a job, I want to love it. I want to connect with it. But I don't get that. So I feel like I'm betraying myself. I feel like I'm doing it to myself. Are you compromising your wants and needs? Lovers and Star Card. I feel like you want eternal love. You want soulmate love. You want like that perfect partner. And the universe has given you father time. The emperor is also controlling, right? He's the ruler. There are all these rules. And maybe this person is very rigid and you need them to be more flexible. Angels just said this person doesn't show a lot of emotion. That's what it is. And you're an emotional person. So you're trying to figure out, Hermit, you may not be on speaking terms with this person, or you might have pulled back to figure out if this is something that you want to contribute to much longer. I get it. Okay, maybe y'all live together. Oh, maybe somebody proposed. Interesting. And yeah, I was going to say you owe them a decision. Don't compromise yourself and your needs and your desires, Pisces. If you know you want somebody who's loving and affectionate and nurturing, this emperor may not be your person. And really, this Queen of Swords is not. I feel like, yeah, they may have a lot going for them. They may be, you know, a business owner, a CEO. They're in a high position. Could be a member of our military. But I just kind of feel like there's an incompatibility here when it comes especially to your moon placement. You could be dealing with the Aries sun Libra moon or Gemini sun Libra moon, and you could be a Pisces sun Cancer moon with Virgo as a rising. Yeah, you're overthinking this. Oh, Angel said, are you attracting unavailable, emotionally unavailable people? Interesting. Well, there's the King of Emotional Unavailability with the Emperor of Emotional Unavailability. Feel like you need to have an honest conversation. You need to speak from your heart, and you need to pay attention in whether or not this person's going to speak from their heart or speak from their head. Ooh, Seven of Swords. Be careful, Pisces, because I kind of feel like this person may double talk you. you know, trying to come across like, oh, well, I know how to love and I know how to do this and I know how to do that. But then, you know, run away. Angels are also saying, too, you want to have this conversation with them, but they could be avoiding you. So that leaves you, yeah, feeling betrayed again. You know what? Ten of Swords and Ace of Swords. You know you have to make a decision. Ace 10 here, Queen, King, Queen here. So you need to have an honest conversation with someone and make a decision for your heart. And there's nothing wrong with following your heart. Also at the same time, use your head, right? Like, think about it, you know, analyze it. You know, may, if you have to, weigh out the pros and cons, you know what I mean? And if they don't hit the mark, right? If you have this Queen of Cups love, but they're emotionally unavailable, let them go. Balance spirituality and practicality. So angels are saying this could be a debate between what you know and what you feel. You know this person is good for you, but you feel nothing. You don't feel love from them. Believe in the impossible, miracles. It's time to release negativity. Ew. And your commitment is being tested. So did you manifest this person, Pisces, and they came in and they check a lot of boxes, but the one box they don't check is the major box? And you would feel like you're betraying yourself the longer you stay with this person. I don't even see a page here. Give me like a page of cups or something. I don't even see that. I feel like you're somebody who requires a lot of love, right? You're happier when you're in when you're receiving love, affection, nurturing. But I feel like whomever it is that you're dealing with, they downgrade love, or love is not a priority to them, right? Emotions are not a priority. At the end of the day, it may not be their love language. You know what I mean? So, I would say to you, kind of just choose wisely. And, you know, use your head, but follow your heart. Let's see what angel answers say. Yeah, I feel like there could be an option here to move in or take this relationship to the next level. Maybe this person wants to commit, right? Okay, now I'm getting a flashback of Carrie Bradshaw and Aiden, I forget his last name, on Sex in the City when he proposed to her. She should not have accepted that proposal because he wanted to get married, but she didn't. And I'm using that because I feel like that could be the energy here in this reading. And judgment, you need to make a decision. How much longer are you going to keep betraying yourself? Four of Pentacles is the love is blocked, right? Something is blocked. I feel like somebody could even be trying to convince you, oh, you don't need all that love. Oh, you may have to let this person go, Pisces. Success, be assertive, stand up for yourself. Stand up for your heart. Opportunity. Nice. And there's something better. I was going to say that opportunity feels like an opportunity to talk. An opportunity to air out any grievances you have. You know, get what's off your mind. Just have an honest conversation. All right, Pisces, I'm going to go ahead and leave it here. If the reading does resonate, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. I love you. Bye.